What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 20 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Brilliant Diamond. It's a dark and stormy night here on Route 215. But this, I believe, is going to be the final leg to Veilstone City. Just going to have a quick look at my map and know for sure. Yes, just go straight east, due east. We'll make it to Veilstone. And we'll worry about this route some other time. I don't think we can actually go that way because we had a bunch of Psyduck blocking that way. So that will have to be on hold. Let me go ahead and lather up this honey tree. I should really go back to check these, but I haven't really had the time. Also trying to level up a few of my lower level Pokemon here. I'm a treasure hunter. Today, the loot is victory from you. Lights burst your bubble, but I have no intention of losing tonight. Ruin Maniac Calvin, he's got two Pokemon. He's going to start with Bronzor, a steel psychic type. This could be problematic for Machop, because of that psychic. And as you can see, I'm also fighting in the rain, which is going to power up water moves and power down fire moves. Also will make the thunder attack 100% accurate. Now, my normal instinct tells me to bring in Monferno, but due to the rain, I think I'm going to go with Haunter instead. Uh-oh. I was hoping I would not have to deal with Confuse Ray. I really don't have a way to counter that. I just got to hope Hex works here. And it does. Probably gonna have to pull Haunter though after this battle. Okay. And now a shield on, which I think is rock or steel. But either way, Machop should be able to handle this. Try low sweep. And unfortunately, it's got the sturdy ability, it looks like. Survive with 1 HP. He's going to use Iron Defense. Not that that's going to really do him any good, since he's only got 1 HP left. And I can just hit a move like Knock Off and knock him off, so to speak. Easy enough for Machop, he levels up. I can't win, you're too much to take. Why, thank you. Alright. So this looks like a very convoluted route here. Found an ether in the middle of the road. And is this guy a trainer? Guess not. A slowdown stop is, I'm sure. I'm only human after all. Yeah, this looks like a very convoluted route. Do unto others as they do unto you. Yep, it's payback. It's good for Pokemon battles, but if you do that in real life, there'll be no end to the fighting, that's for sure. And we had TM66s, which I believe is the payback move. Does double damage if you took damage that turn. Alright, so next up. I found a jar of honey. Actually wasn't even looking at that. So I'll go ahead and proceed here. Anyway, I'm going to cut this tree down. Bring in the wild Bidoof to come do that. This is so good to have in this game. You don't have to teach your you don't have HMs in this game, you just have the moves. I was using a claim, I'm merely feign sleep. Hiyah! I'll see what this guy brings to the table. Black Belt Gregory. Three Pokemon is going to start with a Metatite, a fighting psychic type. I could try bringing in Haunter, but I'm afraid of a move like maybe Psybeam or something like that. But he's really the only way I can counter. Because Monferno, again, we're fighting in the rain. It's not the best environment for him. So I'm going to take a gamble here and try Haunter. Use Feint, and that does not work on me. As it comes to Hex, I'm going to try Detect. only delaying the inevitable. He protects himself once, but the more times you try and use that move in a row, the lesser chance it has of working. He goes down. I gotta think this guy's got more fighting types. Weasel's a level 25. I don't know if he's gonna evolve yet. Now he's got a Machop as well. How about if I had Kadabra with me? Definitely don't want to put Geodude in the line of fire here. Let's just try Hex. It's not going to have super effectiveness, but it's my only real attack here. And it was enough to knock him out in one shot, so kudos to you, Haunter. That insane special attack of yours. And now another meta type. Let's just keep it going. Haunter, I think, is going to sweep this one. He's trying to attack to force me to use more hexes than I intend to. Try to use it twice in a row. I think the chances of that working is cut in half with every successive turn. Though I have seen one person use it four times in succession and get it to work every time. Just luck, I guess. Gurgle. Alright, let's grab this item here. A fist plate, our third Arceus plate. That's obviously the fighting one. Two beings of time and space set free from the original one. Let's backtrack a bit here, because we got another, it looks like another black belt. Check the sharpness of my fighting type Pokemon's moves. Well, how good are they against a ghost? Black belt Derek, what do you got? Krogunk. I think he's poison fighting. Oh, I forgot I had Machop up front. Alright. Well, let's see what we can do with him. I was going to use Sucker Punch. How that works is, if I'm playing an attack and use a Sucker Punch, he immediately gets to go first and hit me. And unfortunately, because this guy's poison type, low sweep's not really going to do much. And I don't think Knockoff's going to do much either. So let me try revenge. That's not doing much either. He's gonna use revenge. Both of us were thinking the same thing. You know what? I'm gonna switch into bring in Haunter. I was thinking about Geodude, but then I realized I'm going up against the fighting type. Even though he's part poison. Gonna try and taunt me. It's gonna force me to only use attack moves. Let's use Hex. Uh-oh. That Sucker Punch being, I think, a dark type move is super effective against Haunter. But we got him. Alright. And we got Black Belt Derek. You've dulled its sharpness. Now, is there anything in here? Oh, it's just wild Pokemon. Pokemon attacks are classified as either being physical or special. A physical attack is based on the attack stat. Likewise, special attacks boost on special attack. Again, 101 there. Alright. Got another Ponyta in the rain. You think that'd be dangerous for a guy like Ponyta? Don't want to lose Machop right now. I think I'm going to play it safe, and I'm going to bring in Geodude for this battle. Bulldoze and this quickly. Flame Charge is not going to do a lot to Geodude. Bulldoze him. It's nice that I have a ground move now. And Carter and Machop both level up. Geodude literally is maybe 10 points away, if that. I'm curious now. I'm actually going to shift Geodude up front. So I can give Machop a rest. You are 9 points away from leveling up. Okay. So we'll swap and we'll put a Geodude up front. I think we're going to need to dip into our stash of Moo Moo Milk. Bought a bunch of these previous episode. It's a better deal than Super Potions, and they heal. I think they're cheaper and they heal a lot more HP. I think I may want to give Haunter another attack. Something to counter those psychic types. I'm going to get rid of Hypnosis since that has the lowest accuracy. And while this bridge is going to pull me to a guard spec, not really going to do much. I see some berry trees over there. I'm going to go ahead and access those. I'm going to get myself some block berries. And some Pecha berries. We'll go ahead and do our due diligence here and plant. Alright, now. Go back this way. That's just gonna take me back. Alright, so, oh, I gotta go this way. Okay, so now what's up here? Cut this tree down. That looks like just a shortcut. Okay. So I'll take the long way in case there's some more battles here, which I do see a trainer over there. Let's just go ahead and fight him. Every drop of sweat I shed makes me that much stronger. What do you got? 3 Pokemon, Black Belt Nathaniel. You're gonna send another Croagunk against me. Now I'm hoping, so it knows that I have a move that's strong against it, so let's use Bulldoze. Let's hope for the best. Flatter, what's that going to do? That's going to crank up my special attack, but confuse me. It's basically the special version of Swagger. Unfortunately, it didn't work on me. And that'll level up Geodude right there. Wants to learn self-destruct. Insane damage, but kills you in the process. No thanks. And now a Machop. Let's bring in Haunter again. A Metatype. How many hexes do I have left? I only have 2 left, so luckily I only need 1 to take this guy down. But pretty soon Haunter is going to be pretty much disabled. Alright, but at least we got him. I don't want to believe this happened, but a loss is a loss. Alright, I think we're in the home stretch here. Let's pull out the Poketch here. Let's get my dousing machine up. Anything around here? Doesn't look like it. But if I run into a few more Ponyta, I could probably use this time to level up Geodude a bit. Because I think you're actually one level away from evolving. So I might take this time, since I'm only 15 minutes into the episode, I might take this time to try and level up T.U.G enough. If I'm going to be fighting these Ponytas, especially in the rain, this will be an advantageous time for me to do this. And I think I may only need like maybe 3 or 4 battles at this rate. There's an item down there I'll probably want to scoop up. Oh, a Cricketune. Now my rock moves will work on this guy too. Tried Bug Bite on me. Actually did some decent damage. You actually survived that move? Really? I was not expecting you to survive a Rock Tomb. Guess you had a bit more in the tank than I thought you did. I may only need one more battle at this point, so let me just go ahead and cut this tree down. I'll grab this item. And Shockwave. This will be good for Luxio. Shockwave is essentially a move that never misses. I should grab some items over here. Grab a full heal. But yeah, and this route's getting even more convoluted. Let's fight this guy. Nothing else up here except a spot to fight wild Pokemon. Are you gonna fight me? Jogging is good for you, but you gotta make sure you're not overdoing it. I guess not. Alright. I'm taking the Veilstone Gym Challenge, but first... Yep, I'm first. Ace Trainer Mayas. This girl could be trouble. A Glameow. Ace trainers are known for being a bit tougher than the normal trainer. This is the first time we're dealing with one in this LP here. I'm gonna try Fury Swipes on a rock. I don't know how effective that's going to be. You got one lucky crit. 3 hits on me. Let's see how you like my Bulldoze attack. I think one more should do it. Reducing their speed as well, but Geodude is by nature a slow Pokemon. Probably to lower. That's why I kept Rock Polish on it, but I haven't used it yet. Alright, so that should put away Glameow, and that should be enough to put Geodude over the hump. That way he can evolve. Yeah, he'll evolve after we're done here. Now you got a Kadabra. Great. This could be extremely problematic. I'm gonna have to rely on Monferno here. So I do not have a good match. I think Kadabra may be able to outspeed Haunter. Let's try Strength. So I know it had low defense, and apparently Strength was enough to take it down. Okay, and Machop levels up as well. Excellent. Wants to learn Vital Throw. Always goes last, but is guaranteed to hit. Now, my guy already has no guard, which means all of his attacks are going to hit anyway. It's a bit more powerful than Revenge. So I think I will actually replace Revenge with Vital Throw. Just for the extra power kick. We beat Maya. You made me lose my confidence. Well, you helped me find mine, and you helped my Geodude evolve. And Geodude evolves into Graveler. The rock Pokemon. Graveler make their homes on sheer cliff faces that have numerous holes in them. to mention they can blow up. I didn't realize there was another trainer here. I'll battle anyone. That's how I'll get better. Girl was hidden in the bushes there. I'm glad I'm taking these guys out separately then. Ace Trainer Dennis. You've got a Monferno. Well, let's test drive my new Graveler. I just gotta hope that Mach Punch. It's like I'm fighting my closest friend here. Bulldoze is gonna be the way to go here. And we got him. Good work, Graveler. Weasel leveled up. Who do you have now? You've got a Gyarados. Boy, I wish I had Luxio with me right now. I know Machop's not going to be able to do much. Well, Hunter, you're getting a little extra work in tonight. And we got the rain going as well. Let me try and confuse it. Maybe this will buy me some time. Good, he hit himself. Alright, so now. Now, doesn't Hex do more damage if it's got a status condition? I wonder if confusion counts as one. I don't know if it did or not, but he's still alive. That's gonna bite Haunter. Alright. Well, I'm out of hexes, I'll have to use payback. He's still standing, but he's still confused. Here comes Leer. Is in the red, but he's snapped out of confusion, and that bite's gonna take down Haunter. Haunter had a great run, but luck finally ran out. I'm gonna try Weasel here. I'll use Bite. And we got him. Haunter did the bulk of the work, and Weasel was able to pick up the scraps there, and Monferno levels up. He's got to be getting close to his next evolution. You won and I lost, but the both of us gained something from this. Yeah. Oh, and Weasel's gonna evolve now, so two evolutions. I thought it was gonna be a little bit later that Weasel was gonna evolve, but no. I'm Ashy Gang. A new Pokemon we haven't seen yet. This is Floatzel. Excellent. Floatzel, the sea weasel Pokemon. It floats using its well-developed flotation sac. It assists in the rescues of drowning people. A natural lifeguard. Nice. Alright, more plants. We got Wiki Berries. What are these? These are Mago Berries. I think these are two berries we haven't seen yet. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and plant them. Yeah, both of these are new. Alright, I think we're at Veilstone now. That's a good thing, because I'm running out of steam here. I wanted to go to Celestic Town, but there were some Pokemon on the way. Yeah, you're talking about those Psyduck. And we've made it to Veilstone City at last. But we got Team Galactic guys here. The Galactic Warehouse. Hey, you. Yeah, you. This is Team Galactic Warehouse. It's no playground for kids. So they're not going to let me through here, huh? Okay. So, can't go that way. Doesn't look like we have a way in here at all. Well, this can't be good if Team Galactus already occupied the town. Well, there's the gym. Looks like I'm gonna need rock climb to get that item over there. This is the new style shop has really been booming. So I wonder if Veilstone City, hewn from rock. So I wonder if there's a way to change your look at some point in this game. What have we got over here? This a lot of stuff to explore here. Veilstone is the city of stone. We even have meteorites. Maylene is Veilstone's gym leader. Wakes the gym leader in Pastoria. Then there's Fantina and Hardhelm. They're all way too tough. I can't even come close to them. Yeah, we'll be seeing those other guys later on. I think Wake is next. I bought a new parasol, but I don't want to get rain out, so I watch TV weather reports. What's this? Veilstone Department. Oh, we got a department store here. Excellent. Well, I'll definitely have to check that out. A couple other houses here. I wonder if there's anything worthwhile. Team Galactus building bugs me. I can't sleep with it looming over me. Who could? Those thorny things on the building, are they supposed to be fashionable? Hey, how y'all doing, PokeFans? Thanks for tuning into the Matchup Channel. Hey, fans, you all have used water-type moves, right? They're, like, not much better than okay against fighting-type Pokemon. They're playing like other Ace Trainers are playing next to me. That's all for today, but don't forget to send me your fan mail. Give it to your bird Pokemon and set them free in the skies. A chance to counter with greatness, that's me, is always possible. See you again. I wonder if that actually happens in this game. If there are people who desire to see them, Pokemon will appear in many different guises. A myth says that Mount Cornet parted Sinnoh in halves. Seeing the Pokemon shells makes you think that the myth is real. Yeah, there's actually two different forms of shells, one, an East Sea version and a West Sea version. We've seen the West one, which is the pink one, and then there's the blue one, which we have not seen. Let me see what else is over here before I hit the Pokemon Center here. This guy's got a giraffe right. Tick tock, tick tock. It swings his pendulum at the same interview. How beautiful. I'll give this to you. We got a metronome. What does the metronome item do again? If boost moves used consecutively, but only until a different move is used. Got a few meteorites down here. I see there's any hidden items down here. Doesn't appear to be. More galactic guys. We have the technical machine that teaches fly stored in the warehouse. They say I can use it if I show them that I deserve it. This will take us right to Lake Valor, which is another one of the lakes. My scarf is blown away by the wind. I wonder where it went. Anywhere close by, maybe? No? Okay. Let's see what's over here. Oh, my boyfriend lost his lens. Where did it go? I've been looking for it with my wide lens, but... So there's definitely some hidden items around here. I'll probably have to do a bit more exploring later on. But yeah, up here is the gym leader, I think. Oh wait, we're up in this area now. And we got a random TM63 here. What move is that? Nasty Plot. So, use Nasty Plot to increase your... increase your special attack by 2 levels. There are many magicians in the world. You know the performance artists? Don't you think that maybe, say, 5% are actually psychics? Have you been to the Veilstone Gym? It's pretty cool. Reminds me of an athletics center. Well, we will be heading there probably in the next episode. Let's see what's in here. Oh, looking a little tired? No, not you. I meant your Pokemon. If you'd like to give a massage to your Pokemon. Would you like that? Sure. I don't know if anybody needs it, but let's give Machop a massage here. Extremely contented. I found a sinister ticket C, so a random sticker as well. And it looks like we do this on a daily basis. My sister's boyfriend is a Scarcrow in Pastoria City. They take strolls there with their Pokemon. The two are really close. Learning about a lot of new people here. And up here, well, it's the gym. Well, here's Dawn. T.U.G, are you going to take the gym challenge? Gee, you keep getting tougher and tougher, don't you? Meanwhile, I went shopping at the department store, and I mean, well, of course, I've been working on my Pokedex, but, well, I'll catch you later. Good, I did not want to have to battle her, because my Pokemon are not in the best shape right now. And my entire lab's going to need an overhaul. I want to finish just exploring this last little bit of town first. I think there's something up here. Oh, this is the Galactic Warehouse. I think we'll save this for later as well. Got a bottle of PP up as well. Alright, so gonna set a battle plan here for next episode. Is there anything up here? No? Okay. I'll worry about this some other time. But what I need to do right now is hit the Pokemon Center. Maylene, the gym leader, is a real cutie. But don't let that fool you. Even grown-ups have trouble with her. So this Maylene's kind of a kid, I guess? If you use the hidden move Fly, you'll be instantly whisked any time you visited before. Yes, I will be looking forward to getting that move relatively soon. Now, I'm not entirely sure if I'm going to be doing the gym very next, or if I have to take care of Team Galactic first. But anyway, let's go ahead, and before I save, I'm going to go ahead and set my team up. Graveler, you've done what you need to do. Let's get Crobat in. Let's get Staravia in. You need some work, though. Let's get Kadabra in. And let's get Gyarados in. Yeah, we're definitely going to need to work on Staravia a bit. He's a bit behind everybody, only at level 21 right now. So I think I'll be putting him at the start of the lineup. Alright, so I think at this point I'm going to go ahead and call it quits here. Next episode, we'll be looking more at Veilstone City, possibly taking on the gym. So until then, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.